like I'm falling. My stick is giving an assignment. By any means, I'm falling. Feel you coming like the weekend. I'll be sad if you're leaving. Girl, you love like a holiday. Got a motherfucker geeking. If I call and you at the mall, can
friends from Krazyfi, and today I have with me Dane, the best. You know, he sounds like an artist from the 90s. It's very amazing, you know, the way he put his song down, like I remember from the 90s or more. And I'm very excited to, you know, share about him with you today. So please, can you introduce yourself with us today?
Yes, you know, I go by the name Dane.
All my
handles is I'm just Dane. It's just a little bit extra. I'm originally from Chicago. I moved to LA when I was 13, and I've been making music since I was a kid. I started in the choir.
Oh, I see. So since you were 13, you've been making music. So yeah, I read about that you were singing tenor in the choir. How was that? You know, how was it all those times?
It's, you know, my family is musically inclined. So I started when I was really young at about 7 or 8 years old, singing in the choir. And it was just every weekend I'd be in, you know, singing church hymns. Yeah. I didn't start like R&B music until I like maybe got towards middle school to high school, like 13, 14. I started to like freestyle and, you know, do my own thing.
Okay. So when did you release your first song?
I released my first song, believe it or not, actually when I was like 16. I was in a group. It was called 4YMG, Four Young Musical Geniuses. Okay. And the first song I ever released was called Ecstasy. And it was some kid stuff, actually.
Yeah.
It was my immersion into the music scene.
Okay. So how back then, I know it was probably different back then, you know, the way streaming platforms work now and how it works back then, it wasn't the same at all. So how did you go about your first release? Did you sell it out? How did it go? How was it?
It didn't go that well. And actually, okay. I'm sorry. I gotta correct myself. It wasn't 2016. That was my first solo. That was my first solo release. It was 2006.
Okay.
That was when I was a kid, young kid. And then, you know, life happened. I went to college and did all the other stuff. But I always came back to music. I always, it kept calling me. So my first solo release was in 2016, 2017, called 86 and Rhodes, actually.
Oh, I see. So the journey has been long for you. It's been a very, very long journey. How have you been? Yeah. What's the challenges you've been facing? What's the challenges you've been facing and the setbacks? How have you been so far?
So obviously I'm independent. So I'm not signed by anyone. I don't have a major label backing. So the big things are always, when it comes to independent artists, is financial. It's like being able to get your releases on streaming platforms. And it's a lot easier today than it was back then. So a lot easier now to do that. But, you know, it's just promoting. Promoting is the biggest thing. It's like, and the hustle and bustle of music. Like, you know, everybody, especially where I am, I'm in LA, everybody does music.
Yeah.
So it's very saturated. So it's hard to stand out amongst the crowd if your music isn't different.
Yeah.
So you just become one of the many. So the real ups and downs is just the consistency of sticking with it and staying on the grind and trying to constantly evolve in this ever-evolving music game.
Yeah, exactly. But I'm seeing that you're doing fine, actually, because I checked up your Spotify and all, you know. It's on the roll. You're having a lot of people come back listening to your music. And although it's very amazing, you know, your song is relatable, you know. Everyone who loved the song from the 90s, the star, the way it's written, they will actually be able to relate to your song and love it. Like you said, you know, you can drive, you can have a long drive with your song, listening to it all day, you know. It's actually there. The mood is there. The technique is there. And its uniqueness is fine and amazing, you know. So besides all that, you know, I know it's not been easy, you know, going through producing your own. I don't know, do you produce your song yourself or do you, you know, you have a producer that do it for you?
So I have a production partner. A lot of the production goes through me and my production partner. We work with a few other producers, but not many.
Okay.
So yeah, I do a lot of the production. I do all my writing. I do all my writing as well as my production partner helps write as well. So it's a team effort.
All right. So Which music artist inspires you, actually? Because I really want to know about that.
Oh, you know, my inspirations, you know, it goes back to, you know, the greatest, Michael Jackson and okay. Prince. Usher, yeah. Usher is my goat. So that's okay. who I grew up on. That's who I grew up on in the 90s was Usher. And so okay. those are my inspirations. I do have some of the new school guys like Chris Brown. Chris Brown's an inspiration okay. and other.
Okay, I see. So, you know, your inspirations, you sounded a little bit like them, but you have a mixture of R&B with hip hop, and it's not, the genre is not specific, you know. It's not specific yes. like R&B, or it's a mixture of all the genres. So can you tell us about that, you know? What
you know, it's so it it came from me actually originally trying to be like everybody else and be a rapper. Okay. I wanted to be a rapper. And so I can spit because I'm a good writer. That's okay. one thing I do pride myself on. I'm a great writer. So okay. I can write bars, but you know, I have a gift that a lot of people don't have, and that's to sing. So I was, for a long time, I was fighting against myself trying to be a rapper when everybody's like, bro, you're a singer. You got something that most people don't have. Yeah. You got a voice. You yeah. can actually sing. And so I was like, all right, well, you know, let's embark on this. Let's take this to the fullest. Let's push it, but let's put a twist with it. Let's make the singing flow kind of like a rapper, but I'm singing, and not just melody rap, yeah. not like just melodic trap rap. It's actually a message behind the music, but it's something that's going to catch your ear.
Yeah, it does catch my ear, you know, and believe me, I guess it does catch other people's ears as well. So have you ever felt like giving up, you know, because you belong, you and believe me, you know, you have been in this a very long time. So if there's anyone that actually should have this experience, that should be you, you know. Have you ever felt like giving up at one point in music?
Yes, and yes. There's always that, you know, if you've been doing it for as long as I've been doing it, and,
yeah.
you know, everybody wants the accolades, and everybody wants the trophies and the Grammys and all the yeah, awards exactly. and all the fame and all. And it doesn't work like that. It doesn't necessarily happen overnight. Like people yeah. think that, like if I blew up tomorrow, everybody think I came out of nowhere. I'd be like, no, I've been doing this for 14, 15 wow. years.
Yeah.
So it does get defeating at times when you do want to hang it all up, where it's like, man, should I just give this up and go do something different? And I was just like, just try something else out. Like, I've been putting so much energy into this. Like, shouldn't I just go make a change in my life? So, like, at times, it gets very, very daunting. And it does. You do want to give up. And I've been guilty of it myself. There's been plenty of times where I've called my crew and I'm like, you know what? This ain't working. So I'm ready to hang it up. And they just, if you don't have the right people around you, then they'll... If you have agreeable people that are like, yeah, I think you should, then I probably would have quit a long time ago. But luckily, I have a few people in my life that are like, nah, bro, you're meant to do this. Like, you get better every year. Like, if you're not getting better, then I would be like, yeah, quit.
I guess.
I try to do it at my own pace as opposed to just trying to keep up with the times.
Yeah.
Because if I do it that way, then I won't feel like quitting all the time.
Yeah, I get you. So your motivation to come back to music always has been the people around you.
Yeah.
Yeah, so that's actually good, you know. That's amazing to know. So your friend, I saw a name in your song, the recent song you released. There is a name there. It's called, it's like a future song. Let me check it out. Rizz, your recent song Rizz with JY. Is that an artist or producer?
That's an artist. That's actually, JY is a local rapper from the Newberry Park area out here in California. Yeah. We're actually doing a joint project called The Black and White Effect that comes out in 2024, early 2024. Okay. So we're working on a 7-song EP. Yeah, we're going to bring the connection. We're going to bring the connection of the R&B with the hip-hop rap.
Okay.
So he's a Italian rapper from New York.
Oh, I see. Well, that's something to check out for, you know. It's something to look out for, you know.
Oh, definitely. It's going to be a vibe.
Yeah. So what was the inspiration behind your new song, you know, the latest one you have, Rizz? What's the inspiration behind it?
Oh, it's just the swag. It's the swag, you know. You know okay. about that. You know about the Rizz. You gotta have the sauce all the time. You gotta have the okay. Rizz. When it comes to the ladies, like yeah. I'm not a single man. I'm in a relationship. But when I was single, I had to have my Rizz right. You had to have that Rizz, that charisma. Yeah. That's what it's an abbreviation of charisma, like meaning having a bubbling personality, like you're sociable, you're personable, people like you, people like to talk. So the song came about when me and Jay were in the studio and we're like, yo, we need to make a song just about dopeness.
Yeah.
And so I was like, well, what about we talk about charisma? He's like, no, we got to call it Rizz. I was like, perfect.
Okay, that's how it came about. You know, it's just like, yeah, I get it now. So, but the song is very melodic. You know, there's a lot, you know, going on around. There's a lot going on in it and all, you know, it's a perfect produce, you know. But so besides this song, do you plan on releasing anything at all this year besides the one that's coming out in 2024?
So for this year, I did release an album at the beginning of this year, which I'm still promoting. I've released a couple of singles. I performed at a fashion show and debuted or premiered a new song that's coming out in 2024. Okay. That Rizz was probably, I may drop another single end of this year, or I may drop it right at the top of next year. But this year, it may be a shutdown for these last 2 months. Maybe just take this time to enjoy the holidays.
Yeah, yeah.
I already have, because I have a catalog. I have a large catalog already of music that's already out, available for listeners. So obviously, you check out I'm Just Dane on Spotify or Apple Music, wherever you get your music. I've got plenty of songs people can listen to while I get ready to drop this new stuff I'm bringing in 2024.
Okay, all right, that's cool. So have you ever had any opportunity at some point, you know, and you turned it down at that time because you felt that, nah, I don't need it right now, but today you regret it, you wish that you didn't turn it down, you wish that you hopped on that opportunity at that time, you know, maybe it would have changed things for you, you know, differently?
Well, opportunities that I like missed out on, things like
just like the opportunities that you had, but for some reason, you felt like you didn't want to do them back then, you know. But
I definitely don't regret the decisions about any opportunities that I've had in like the past, because I had the opportunity to actually sign with a label when I was like 16, and I declined it because it was a slave contract, and my grandmother is an attorney. So when she read the contract, she's like, you better not sign that contract.
Yeah.
I was like, I'm kind of grateful that I didn't sign the contract, because I probably wouldn't be making the music that I'm making right now if I had to be at some label, trapped on some label where they're making all the money.
Yeah, exactly. So being independent and being in a record label, which one do you prefer right now, you know?
Well, if the right situation comes about, then definitely I'll be down to sign with a record label. But staying independent where I can release music at my own whim, whenever I want, and keep control of all most of it. Yeah. But you know the saying, 100% of nothing is nothing. So if the right situation comes along, then I'm definitely willing to sit down and you know, sign that dotted line.
Yeah. But so far being independent, how have it been, you know? Because it's independent, 100% of everything. So whatever you want, whatever, that's what you're gonna get. So how have you been?
Well, it's just the same as being an artist that's independent or on the label. Like it's gonna be ups and downs. There's always ups and downs. There's ebbs and flows of anything you do. So being independent obviously is great for releasing music and doing that. But when it comes to promotion, it's definitely great having a record label that has the marketing budget to market you.
Exactly.
So it's always a grind being an independent artist as opposed to being a labeled artist.
Yeah, true. Which music artist would you love to have a feature track with, you know? Which
Drake.
Artist right now?
Drake.
Yeah,
come on,
that's
man.
A quick answer,
come
you
on,
know?
Man. Drizzy. Yeah, Drizzy, you know, Chris Brown, you know, Usher, obviously. So.
Yeah.
A lot of the top artists, but you know, there's a lot of great artists out there that I would love to feature with. I'm not holding back any artists.
Okay, but Drake is your number one because you didn't hesitate. You know, that was the first name
that
came to your mind.
Let me get that Drake feature.
So, and you yourself, you're open for collaboration with other independent upcoming artists. Let's say they want to collaborate with you, you know, have a feature track with you, you know, are you open for that?
Of course. If I'm the main reason or the main way that I would select an artist is if I like the music. If I like the music that you're making and okay. I feel that I can add value to that music, then of course I'd be open to collaboration. But if it's not something that's not my cup of tea, then most likely not.
I see. So you're open for independent artists to actually, you know, shoot their shot, you know, like talk to you, reach out to you, and probably, you know, then you can review yourself to know if you want to work with them or not, depending on what they're putting out.
Yeah, exactly.
Okay. So everyone should know. With your experience right now, you know, what advice can you give to upcoming independent artists, you know, who are actually trying to give up right now? What's your advice?
If I'm thinking of any independent artist that needs kind of like a pep talk, or just kind of like to keep going, all you can do is stay consistent and keep going. As long as you believe in what you're doing, as long as you believe in what you're doing, and you love music, you have to have a passion for music. Like,
exactly.
Sometimes it's hard to have to keep that passion when nothing's you feel is going your way. But you just have to keep going. All I would tell an upcoming artist is stack days, keep working on your craft, keep writing, keep making songs, just figure out who you are as an artist. Figure out who you are as an artist and don't try to be like everyone else. Don't try to assimilate to like the music industry of what they think artists should be. Be you, because being you is the thing that's going to shine through. It's going to make people want to make music with you, is you being 100% original, authenticity.
The instrumental or the lyrics, when you listen to a song, which one do you go for first?
Obviously beats. The beats gotta catch me like right off the bat. It's gotta make me want to write. Because if it inspires me to write, then easy. But if I don't have a good beat that like catches my attention, that makes me want to like put some flows to it, then I don't even do it.
Okay. Well, when you listen to songs, let's say each time you listen to song or you want to listen to an upcoming independent artist, what do you go for first? The beats, or do you want to see what he's saying in the song?
When I listen to an artist, I definitely want to hear what they're talking about.
Exactly.
Like the beat is very dope, but if I can't relate to the music, like it's pointless, because I'm just listening for the beat.
Yeah.
So mostly when I hear, if I'm listening to an artist, especially if it comes to a collab, I want to hear what you're talking about, because obviously I'm not going to get on a song talking about murder, kill, death. That's not my tea. So I definitely gotta attach to the lyrics.
Yeah. Okay. So you've been on shows. Have you events, gigs, and all that? You've always been invited to that. So how have it been going for you? Like, what's from your experience, you know, how have you been? And, you know, can you share with us about this behind the scenes of these shows, how it's been for you?
Well, it's shows are fun. Shows are definitely like the vibe. Like once you think about it, if you've been making music in the studio, the first thing, you can't wait to perform it in front of people. And, you know, give people a taste of what you've been working on. Yeah. So, like, shows are definitely, like, what I live for. Like, I'm a performer. So I love performing and performing the music that I create for people that I hope can relate to it. Like, I've had all different types of shows. I've actually been international. I've been to Germany and performed at a festival.
Whoa, that's big.
I want to do more international stuff and get more internationally known. And out of the, you know, the States for a while, maybe a long time.
I see.
But definitely, performing is like right now. I'm kind of in album mode, finishing up this album, so I'm more in the studio than performing. But January 2024, and all the next year, I'm gonna be out in the streets. I'm gonna be outside performing all these new records that we drop.
So. Which international artist do you think you want on your track? You know, there's some from the States, just an international artist. Which one do you vibe
with? Well, It's there's a few. So there's a few. I would go with Burner Boy.
Yo, that's different. I see. Yeah.
I would go with Burner Boy. Yeah. Then I would go down, you know, I go down to my Latinos and go with Bad Bunny.
Okay.
So, you know, I'd have a few different artists that I would do that are international artists, people that are transcendent.
Yeah. So which means you listen to Afrobeats more. You tend to vibe to it as well. Well, Burna Boy is okay. He's kind of he is okay actually. And right now he's taking over the charts, you know, real fast. He is taking over the charts. So for your album that's coming out next year, how do you have other artists featured on it, and how many of them, or is it just you and Jay?
It's just me and JY. It's just a dual artist EP. Okay. No other people. It's gonna be seven tracks of just like, you know, different.
can you share more about these tracks? You know, what should we expect? You know, so the expression really behind them too. Yeah.
So for people to have something to expect, Rizz is actually one of the tracks that's on the EP.
Okay.
So that was the first single off of the new EP.
Oh, I see. Yeah.
So it's got the combination of the singing and the rapping. And then I want to kind of keep it under wraps right now because, you know, we're almost completed with the EP. So I just want to, I'll put the name out there, the Black and White Effect with JY. Yeah. And I'm just like, it's coming.
Yeah. But as Rizz is already out, you know, should we expect a music video? Because since it's going to be on the track, you know, at least there should be a music video for it too. Do you have any plans for that?
There actually is a music video for Rizz, and it's on my YouTube page.
Okay. That's definitely what I'm going to put on this, you know, in the interview, in the intro. That's the music video I'm going to put on that.
So you can check out. It's smack dead and center on my my actual private page, imjustdane.com. You can watch the Rizz video there as well. So, yeah, we do have a video for that track. We're planning on doing a couple more videos for this EP. And once we drop it, we may drop one single before, or we may just drop the whole EP at one time.
Okay, so there's a possibility before January next year that you might drop one of the singles from the EP.
Yes, there's a possibility. But I do also have a solo single that I'm going to release in February of 2024.
Okay. This is, there's a lot to look out for. And it's really exciting as well. Everything sounds really, really exciting. And I can't wait to, I'll keep checking. I keep following, you know, to see what's coming out, to see what you're doing. And, you know, I'll keep checking for that. So can you say your handles, you know, so everyone will know, YouTube, Instagram, Twitter, whatever it is, so people can check you out.
Okay, so mainly, I know everybody has all the different handles, but, you know, my handle is mainly the same on all platforms. So if you want to check me out on YouTube, it's youtube.com/imjustdane. You can check my website out at imjustdane.com.
Yeah.
Instagram is /imjustdane. TikTok is imjust_dane. And then, you know, those are mainly the platforms that I'll be on. All the other stuff, I'm not really on it.
I see. Okay, this is, you know, I'm really excited that today we have the opportunity, you know, to get to you, you know, hear more about you. And it's very entertaining, you know, because your music is really entertaining. Believe me, I read what you wrote on Spotify, you know, about listening to your song, vibing to it, and how the girl can buy a ticket the next day after vibing to your song.
Exactly. Yeah.
So it's actually very engaging, you know. It's, you know, these days, music, I always say this, you know, I know some people will criticize me for saying it. I always say music is not the way music used to be anymore, you know.
No, it's not. And it's slowly coming back, though. Slowly coming back to a time where people are starting to pay attention to what the lyrics are as opposed to just the beat.
I'm really hoping for that, you know, because to be honest, right now, what the actual famous people, they are not doing, and they're not putting out music the way it should be. And the independent artists, they are the ones putting out real music and no one is actually listening to it. You know, that's very sad, you know.
That's a fact.
That's a fact. Very sad. it's now, you know, popularity over talent. You know, everyone is, it's like everyone is chasing the money and no one is chasing the talent anymore. So if you're famous on IG, then you become a rapper.
Yeah.
Whatever, you know, it's like, and people are just chasing these clouds and it doesn't happen. So your music is one of those musics out there that, you know, it's vibing the way it should be, especially Rizz. It's vibing the way, you know, it's something you can relate with. And when you're listening to it, you have that feel with it as well. And that's what music is all about. So I really appreciate the fact that you put that music like that as well. Really appreciate it. And I know a lot of other people is going to appreciate it and they're going to listen to it. Of course, you have a lot of streams because people vibe into it, you know, they love it as well. That's why it's there, you know.
Yeah, Rizz, when we released Rizz actually, you know, got a great response. So I'm thinking that the CP that we're going to release in 24, the music, that just be ready.
Yeah, and because you're working with Jay too. So
Yeah.
But then he don't seem to have any profile online or something like that. Is he just upcoming as well? How is that?
He's an upcoming artist. He does have a profile on Spotify. He does have an Instagram. You can go to, I'll throw out his handles. His handle on Instagram is the official JY. And it's the same thing on all other platforms as well. So he does, he's an upcoming artist as well. He's a dope rapper. Okay. It's definitely a dope collab.
All right. We're really, really excited to have you here today. And believe me, I want you back here in January 2024 when your EP is out, because I want to break it down one by one, all the tracks, you know. I really want that as well.
You got it. You got the exclusive. Don't worry. You got it.
All right. Thank you very much, Dave. And I really appreciate it. And I know this is not going to be the last interview. We're going to have much more. And I'll check you out every day and stay updated with you to see what's coming out. And I'll share it as well on Instagram and everywhere as much as I can as well. Thank you very much.
Definitely. For being here. I appreciate that. Thank you for having me.